In this video, we'll be taking a look at the research on cervical artificial disc replacement. If you have persistent neck pain with shooting arm pain that has not improved despite the appropriate treatments prescribed by your doctor, it can be frustrating. For a specific group of people, a cervical artificial disc replacement may be an option. We should avoid sugarcoating this discussion. The decision for cervical disc replacement is not based solely on pain and frustration. It works well for specific complaints coupled with specific findings on tests and physical examination. Understand your complaints and have the discussion about the chance of success with your surgeon. The surgical technique is as follows. A cut is made to the front of your neck, and your surgeon will carefully move the muscles, arteries, windpipe, and food pipe away from the front of your spine. The specific disc and the corresponding bony vertebrae are identified. The surgeon will enter the vertebral disc space and mark the center of each of the two adjacent vertebrae. This helps facilitate accurate placement of the implant. A self-retaining retractor is placed over the disc space, and a discectomy and decompression are performed. Once the disc is removed, the spinal cord and the nerves are unpinched. Extra steps are then taken to ensure proper fit, placement, and position of the artificial disc implant. What are the indications? Specifically, it depends on the patient. Cervical artificial disc replacement may be preferable to cervical spinal fusion surgery. If you have intolerable pain despite time, activity changes, and therapies, and diagnostic tests such as MRIs or CTs demonstrate a pinching that corresponds to your physical exam findings, you may benefit from surgery. Your options may include removal of the disc and replacement with the artificial disc implant. But each person must consider their individual considerations before selecting the disc replacement option. Remember, there's never a guarantee, and you, the patient, must understand why a disc replacement versus a traditional fusion versus no surgery would be recommended. There are nuanced differences, but some situations will cause a surgeon to recommend one option over another. For example, patients with poor bone quality or auto fusion findings are not a good candidate for a cervical disc replacement. The longevity of disc replacements. Although there's data that demonstrates the favorable short-term outcomes of cervical disc replacement, there are very few studies that have monitored the long-term outcomes of this option. A few of the long-term studies show superior disc replacement outcomes compared to fusion surgery, which is a promising future for cervical disc replacement. The concern is that cervical disc replacement surgery may need better implants to minimize the wear and tear of the implant and to extend its longevity. The rationale for cervical disc replacement is the preservation of motion, thus decreasing the stresses on the adjacent level. Theoretically, this should avoid or lessen future complaints associated with degeneration of the level below or above the artificial disc. Prevention of adjacent level disease. In a 2-year post-surgery follow-up study, 2-level disc replacement patients showed a lower incidence of adjacent segment disease and a lower rate of reoperation compared to that of the standard 2-level fusion. In general, cervical disc replacement showed better outcomes compared to the fusion, but we must be cautious because it's a short-term study. On the other hand, the results are positive. The FDA has approved 2-level cervical disc replacement for certain devices. Long-term studies still need to be reviewed regarding cervical disc replacement for more than 2 levels. While the preliminary data looks encouraging, it's still too early for approval. In the future, hopefully, artificial disc replacements will prove to lessen the development of adjacent level complaints. Compared to 5 years ago, cervical disc replacement has become a more mainstream surgery, with some studies showing better outcomes compared to 2-level fusions. Longer-term studies still need to be conducted to ensure consistency of outcomes and to prove the longevity of the replacement option. The results thus far have been promising. Cervical disc replacement remains a reasonable option for those considering cervical disc surgery, but always remember there are risks, benefits, and alternatives to every situation. even more so as technology continues to advance. Just make sure you're selecting the best option for your particular situation. Remember that the reason for the use of the technique or the choice to not pursue an operation are legitimate issues that should be explored by anyone considering any form of surgery. Until next time, this is Dr. Shim.